What up, fellow fanboys, fangirls, Fandom of Force here, and welcome back to Dragon Age Inquisition. Now, we met with Joseph, we found where Josephine is. Met with Mother Giselle, I'm gonna question her some more a little bit. But right now, ooh! What do we got here? Children with drones today, blah blah blah. Betrayer. What betrayer? Or the only betrayer I could think of is the Dread Wolf or something. I may have dabbled in some Dragon Age fanfic. There was not too many spoilers, so there weren't too many spoilers, so most of it was AU. AU has an alternate universe. Okay, so we have children on Zara's day, okay. Why don't we talk to this lady?
You're the Herald. Or, well, the one they're calling the Herald, anyway. It's odd to see them accepting a mage as their hero. It must be easier because you're not human. They already see you as different from those of us who lived in circles. My
Obviously.
Name is Maeve. I research demons and other creatures. Seeker Pentagast and I use what I find to help the soldiers fight them.
So you're a mage.
You said you were a mage?
No, just an apprentice. Circle mages must prove themselves in a ritual called the Harrowing. I was never very good at magic. I've got just enough talent to be a danger to other people. But when the mages rebelled, people like me had nowhere to go. The Templars would have killed us.
What?
Luckily, Seeker Pentagast took me in.
What?
Along with the Tranquil I was protecting.
You said Cassandra has you researching creatures.
Yes.
Thank God for Cassandra.
If you find anything interesting in your travels,
oddly enough,
you bring
Cassandra is actually her
I may
real
be able
name.
To find some weakness our soldiers can exploit when
like Phantom Enforcer is a name. Is it, okay.
At the least, some materials are useful for making potions or gear for the Inquisition.
All right, just let me wrap this up.
You said that you were keeping some of the Tranquil safe.
Yes, the mages took some of them when my circle rebelled. The rest were forgotten. Most circle mages look down on the Tranquil, or try to pretend they don't exist. They don't have any emotions. They can barely take care of themselves, can't defend themselves at all. It's a shame. I like them better than most people.
I'm glad they have someone who cares about them.
They deserve better. They're polite, they're rational, and they'll never get angry at you. When they study, they have a focus no normal person could ever match. But the Templars, even some of the mages, mistreated them just because they could. The Tranquil never fought back. If not for that, I don't know. Doesn't really matter now.
Okay, so yeah, Cassandra is actually my real name. Phantom Force was a name I came up with from a YouTube channel with my friends. I wanted to make some YouTube content because it looks so much fun to do, and I found it very less stressful. Like, I find it like it's like a stress reliever to me in a way, which is weird, I guess, to many. But yeah, so we were coming up, and I'm like, why don't you call yourself? I'm like, why don't you name yourself after your favorite TV show? TV show or fandom? I'm like, well, TV show. That might be a copyright problem right there. In a fandom, I'm a fan of several. And one of my friends says, you could be like enforcing the fandom, your favorite fandoms. And then one of my friends had a brain. I'm gonna quote Jimmy Neutron here. And that's Jimmy Neutron from Nickelodeon here. Had a brain blast. And she said, why don't you name yourself Fandom Enforcer? My friends and I, that's how I got the name. So if it wasn't for my friends, I wouldn't have a YouTube channel, as they've always been there to back me up.
I'm surprised that even an apprentice mage wouldn't join the rebellion.
I don't like using magic to fight. I'm not good at it either. I liked studying. I liked performing rituals that helped us unlock the secrets of the Veil. I liked having the Templars around to keep us safe.
Mages need protection. I wish more of them could see that.
I was born into a Dalish clan. I lived there until my magic manifested. The Dalish cannot risk having too many mages in one clan. And I was one more than they could bear. But they gave me a pack and sent me into the woods to find my own life. I was 7 years old.
I'm so sorry.
I stumbled into a village, starving and cold a few weeks later. I started using magic to scare predators away. The villagers saw me make fire in my fist. They were terrified and wanted to kill me. Templars saved me from them. They gave me food and clothes and took me to the Circle. I've seen what life is like without the Templars, and I want no part of it. I just want to study.
Why study creatures?
Why did you decide to research dangerous creatures?
I like the outdoors. The idea of the outdoors, anyway. When some monster is coming at you, glowing eyes and burning claws, it's terrifying. But once you know how it works, you can deal with it. It's just another part of the world. So much of this world is only frightening because we don't understand it.
All right. Got something for you.
I found something the demons left behind. Can you use it?
Yes, that's very helpful. Just leave it there and the Tranquil and I will examine it.
All right. So over here?
We can use that. Please tell me if you find something. If you find anything, please bring it in.
Here we go. There's more. Oh, I can't loot. Damn it. Okay, let's see if there's anything for Josephine. More Josephine.
Greetings.
Why did you join the Inquisition?
I'd been considering leaving my post in Antiva for a new challenge when Leliana recruited me. There's such unrest in Thedas, and the Inquisition seems a promising method to stop it. It's
party
to
chat,
everyone's
right
benefit
party
to
chat.
Prevent the Mage-Templar
time,
conflict
tyrant,
from
sorry.
Spreading further.
So, was it the prospect of stability that drew you here?
The full impact of the Mage Rebellion has yet to be felt. And that was before the death of the Divine. The violence must be curbed before we see it turn to full-scale war.
I can only imagine the bloodshed if it escalates further.
I'm afraid history holds many examples of what will happen if it does.
True. Yeah, how did you meet Liliana?
How do you and Liliana know each other?
We moved through similar circles in Norlai. I believe we actually met in Val Royale. Liliana was quite an accomplished player of the game by then.
Okay, what's the game?
What exactly do you mean when you say the game?
Forgive me. The game refers to the slow duels of influence among the noble and powerful of Orlais. It's a rather light-hearted name for the matter, but Orlesians are fond of playful touches.
Alright. What are your duties?
What exactly does your job entail?
I meet with ambassadors from various factions and countries, and cement alliances with them. We are a young cause. Diplomacy is essential to our credibility.
Okay. So you're a representative.
Then you speak for the Inquisition with these nobles.
I do. Someone must foster goodwill on our behalf, as well as prevent controversy as news of us spreads.
Mm-hmm. Are we that controversial?
How heavily are our actions scrutinized?
Make no mistake. Every noble house, every throne, is waiting to see what the Inquisition does next. Many are willing to pledge support, if offers are made in just the right fashion. I intend to see that they are.
Okay. Can you tell me about yourself? Investigate. What does your family
do? What business are the Monteliers in, exactly?
We began as merchants. My ancestors founded the first trade routes to Rivain. We once sent entire fleets across the Waking Sea.
Once?
But not anymore?
Ah, no. These days, our vessels are a touch more modest.
That says something. What about your work?
What did you do before coming here?
I had the great honor of serving Antiva's crown as ambassador to Orlais. I'm also first in line to become the head of House Montelier, though my siblings attend to our mercantile affairs.
And are you doing this for... Yeah, I gotta know.
How strong are your past loyalties?
I gotta know.
I would never have given up my position if I did not intend to fully commit to the Inquisition. We cannot fall back on borders. Antiva is as threatened as any country by the rebellions. If anything, the alliances I forged there may help our current cause.
Will we have more causes? Yes.
Do you think the Inquisition will continue after we seal the breach?
If we prove ourselves by healing the breach, people may turn to us for other things. Mm-hmm. Protection, counsel, justice. The Inquisition offered these once to those in need.
Honestly, it may sound stupid, but I think this is a good question.
Tell me. Do you believe I was saved by Andraste at the Temple of Sacred Ashes?
I should much like to believe so, Your Worship. The miracles Andraste performed were so long ago, they're difficult to picture. If it were truly her and the fate who saved you... Well, in any case, many already believe you walk in the Maker's light.
All right. Thanks, Josephine.
Let's speak later.
Goodbye.
See you later, Josephine.
Sky Maker, you were the sky. When there was no earth, you were the earth. When there was nothing, you were everything.
Oh, Maker's their version of God. Gotcha.
Greetings, Herald of Andraste.
Let's talk about that change.
I don't believe I've had the chance to speak candidly with a revered mother. Can you tell me about the Chantry?
And if you guys want to read this, just pause the video at some parts so you can read. Alright.
Of course. Too many think that the Chant of Light should only be sung by humans. The truth is that knowledge of the Maker and Andraste should be open to all who wish to learn of him. We believe the Maker created us, and that mankind's sinful nature caused him to turn away. With Andraste's blessing, the Maker will forgive mankind once the Chant of Light is sung from all corners of this world.
What about Exalted March?
There were calls for an Exalted March to put down the Mage Rebellion. What was your opinion?
It was ignorant gossip. An exalted march only succeeds when it carries the will of the people. Even then, it cannot be undertaken lightly. People are too easily frightened. We cannot destroy everything they fear. An exalted march is justified only against a true threat to this whole world. It is an offense to the Maker to use it as a political bludgeon, or as a means of spreading the Chant of Light.
And the March of the Dales?
What about the exalted march that conquered the elves?
That is a hotly debated matter in some circles of the Chantry. The elves had conquered Mont-Saint-Marde and threatened Val-Royeau itself. They were not helpless victims. But even then, Orlais was the only nation to provide troops. It was hardly an exalted march of all the faithful. The Maker wishes his world to spread by example, not by war. We win no converts with blood.
Hear ya. Yeah, I noticed that most of the Chantry is made by human women, so I kinda know.
Why does the Chantry allow only human women to become priestesses?
The official doctrine is that elves and dwarves have turned further from the Maker than humanity. And as for men, the chant holds that they are more vulnerable to anger or passion. But in truth, it is simply political. Added after Andraste's death, like too many of our beliefs.
What is your stance on magic?
Andraste put it simply. Magic must serve man, not rule over him. However, those words must be put into the proper historical context. Andraste led a rebellion against the Tevinter Imperium, whose magisters controlled most of the world at the time. Even then, she never called for all mages to be put to death. She believed in peaceful coexistence.
I don't recall the Chantry being as tolerant of magic as you describe.
No. The Chantry is an imperfect vessel, pulled in every direction by those who would steer its course. Yet the Templars rebelled precisely because Divine Justinia was not restrictive enough. Perhaps the Inquisition will find a better way.
We might. Maybe.
Farewell.
Farewell.
I also think you're looking around a little bit more. Who knows, there might be some loot. I said there might be some loot. There's loot.
You built for them the golden city, the center of all creation. And for a time you dwelled among them. Watched over.
You guys ready? Let's go in. You have now access to missions. Mission operations take time and bring the Inquisition resources and rewards. Only one mission per advisor can't be active at a time. Some missions have a preferred type. Okay. Mission results in less than required. One are taken by an associate advisor. Missions may also provide different awards depending on which advisor completes them. Okay.
You were saying something about Cullen?
Yes. Haven has limited space for our soldiers to train. Perhaps we could set up something over here.
Do this. Yeah, I bet this is Colin. Yes, I was right. Okay, and that means connections is Josephine. All right. Let's go check for Alden. Inquisition soldiers have gone missing in the marshy reaches of Southern Ferelden. Because the region is largely uncharted, finding them will be difficult, but the Inquisition's advisors are determined to find out what happened and, if possible, bring their people back. Send my people and few scouts who could be more okay. Okay. Okay, let's do this one. Follow Mire, they're being outlashed by a bar. Are you kidding me? Let's do this. Okay, good. Oh no. Ah, bad. So this confirm. And my dogs are being whiny little. Ugh. And if you guys hear noise in the background, these are my dogs or my sister talking on the phone. Who knows? We might get more power for this. To visit Battle Royale. Why do I have a feeling something in Battle Royale is gonna go get all fucked up?
Thank you for coming. Maybe you can solve this mess. Our missing patrols are being held hostage by Avar, barbarians from the mountains.
What are they doing in a bog?
That's the thing. Their leader, he wants them to fight you, because you're the herald of Andraste.
What do they have against Andraste?
Well, the Avar think there are gods in nature, as in, the sky has a god and the forest. The Avar say you're claiming to be sent by one, and they'll challenge the will of your god with their own. I think their leader's just a boastful little prick who wants to brag he killed you.
I've survived demons. I think I can handle myself against some southern barbarians.
Yeah, you'd think. But they're a brawny bunch. Getting to our troops won't be easy. You'll have to fight your way through undead. Wait, you're not squeamish about undead, are you?
It doesn't matter. I'm not letting the Avar butcher the Inquisition's people.
I appreciate it. The Avar are holed up in the castle on the other side of the Fallow Mire. Maker willing, the Inquisition's people are still alive.
All right.
Dispatch for you.
Let's hear it.
Might interest you, sir.
What is it?
See for yourself, sir.
Wait, that was a quest? Okay. Let's see. Let's try getting over here, shall we? And before I go, I'm gonna just save. Before anything, and before any more shit happens. See if there's anything around here. Diary Peter Marsh. Garner's just too sick. Read. What the fuck? Out of the wall, of course.
Ah.
There's elf root. There's more elf root. And this is me banging around. Banging the door around like it's nothing. What's in here? Oop.
Look, signs of a plague.
It must have been a terrible illness. No one's come to reclaim the land. No one living, at any rate.
Gee, Solas. What gave you that impression? Let's go. Go. More blood nuggets, I'll take that in it. Is there a way in? It's in. Hold on, Lauren, that's me where my hairbrush is. You need that one?
Yeah. Where is that?
Oh, that's the character I made.
Where are these people?
My party. They're characters of the game that joined my...
You're talking to them?
No.
Can they hear you?
No. Mm-hmm. It's a video game characters, Lauren. So my little sister's like questioning me what Dragon Age is.
Oh, who are you talking to then?
I'm making a gameplay!
Oh.
I think I just freaked my sister out. There, get out the water. Try going this way. What's... Can I go in here? What's this?
Careful. Disturbing the water draws them out.
Guys, come on.
Is that a beacon of some sort?
What the fuck just happened?
Look out!
Oh, that's canceled.
to draw out the undead. We could use them to fight on dry land.
Keep an eye out for more, then.
Okay. Oh, I'm not going all the way in the middle of the water. Holy fucking shit, what the fuck? What the fuck is that? It's like a combination of a hippo and an alligator. That fucking scared me. Alright, looks like we got another one, guys. Let's light it up and kick some demon ass. Oh wait, we got something. Comes the undead.
Who do you think is the toughest? Josephine, Liliana, or Cassandra?
I'm right here, you know.
That doesn't rule you out, Seeker.
Cullen's not up for consideration?
Curly? They just keep him around to look pretty.
Okay, I'm laughing because one, the look pretty part is two. Curly? Damn, Varric. You have a way with nicknames. I'm gonna leave here. Let's see what we got here. Okay. Now let's get back on the path and get some yellow. We can set up camp here.
So, set up camp or keep moving?
Try characters. Okay. Okay, so let's have to see. Oh crap, everyone's forgot Eric. Oops. Okay, I got everybody. I'm gonna save here and end the video right here. Thank you guys so much for stopping by to watch this. You guys can check out my other the rest of my content by clicking my name below in the description box and hit that subscribe button if you guys want to be kept up to date with any new videos. Until next time, Fandom Enforcer out.